there's your assignment, Jed. Mr. America himself, the buffalo.
Buffalo roam. Oh, what a shame if he ever becomes extinct. He's so much a part of this country.
Well, they came mighty close to disappearing. You know, at one time there were over 40 million buffalo in America. By 1887, the commercial hide hunters had killed off all but 1,000.
Really, Corey? But if the buffalo is so scarce and you're trying to preserve them, why do you hold these annual hunts? Why kill off more of them?
Well, that's the only way we can be sure that they will survive, by keeping this herd thinned out. You see, his 40 million ancestors had an unlimited range. But now there's only enough range and enough forage to support a limited number. You know what would happen if we didn't have these hunts and let this herd increase in size?
Some of them would be hungry or starve to death.
That's right. They'd eat themselves right out of house and home. Many of these animals would die.
I see. So, Corey, the reason for these hunts is not for the sportsman who wants to kill a buffalo, but more for the sake of the herds themselves.
And that's what I want you to put in your article, so the American people will understand.
I see.
You think it'll make a good story?
I certainly do.
You know, but what I ought to have is a human interest angle. Something that'll... well, that'll give it life and tie it together.
Over there. There's an old rogue buffalo bull that's been ostracized from the herd.
Kicked out?
Kicked out, butted out, and trampled out. The young bulls really gave it to him, but good.
But why?
Who knows? Maybe even his best friends wouldn't tell him. But they don't want him around, and he knows it. And he also knows if he tries to get back into the herd, they'll give him the same treatment all over again.
Well, maybe that picture will make the front cover of the magazine. Wish me luck, Corey.
I do. And an article inside by Jed Bingham. Not just for your sake, but for the buffalo, too. Here, you out of here in a minute. Come on now. Be grateful to you the rest of his life. Come on, Lassie. You know, it's funny, whenever there's a baby animal in trouble within miles of her, Lassie seems to sense it, makes a beeline right for it. Try it out and take a look at the roundup.
All right.
Down there. Starting to separate the older bulls and the barren cows now.
Corey.
Why? Dan Ryder, Jed Bingham.
It's nice to meet you, Mr. Bingham.
How do you do, sir?
Jed's going to do an article on your buffalo hunt for his magazine.
Yeah? Good.
Well, Lassie, they're keeping you busy?
All the time.
How do you pick the animals to be hunted?
Well, you see, we know that this grazing land will support around 200 head, no more. Anything over that's harmful to the whole herd. So we'll round up the older and the poorer bulls first, and then we'll take the barren cows. We'll hold them in the corral until a hunting permit is issued for each animal. Our object is to constantly upgrade the quality of the herd. Eventually, we won't have anything but prime breeding stock here, and the buffalo will never become extinct.
Then this hunt is really a conservation measure, isn't it?
It sure is. At least it will be if I can ever stop talking long enough to get it started. I'll see you later.
Thank you.
pretty near the end now. He's got a few barren cows left. Obviously, no barren cow. And this hunt is over.
That the American buffalo is going to be with us for a long time to come.
And you know the best part about this whole thing? One day when my boy looks at the back of an old nickel, he'll run up to me and ask, "Daddy, what's that?" And you know I'll be able to bring him up here and show him that on the hoof.
Girl. You know, Jed, that calf would have been an orphan if it hadn't been for Lassie. Say, how's that for a human interest angle to your story?
Terrific. But there's one more picture I need to make the story complete.
What's that?
A picture of Lassie and you.